guys, Orly Wamba here, founder of LifeVestInside, and I want to thank each and every one of you for deciding to kick off your week with me on the weekly Kindness Kickoff with Orly, coming at you every Sunday, where I do reading from my book, Kindness Boomerang, How to Save the World and Yourself Through 365 Daily Acts. And then I give you, myself, and all of us out there an exciting kindness challenge based on the reading. For those of you that want to grab a copy of the book, you could pick up your copy directly on the Life Vest Inside website by going to lifevestinside.com. All proceeds from the book go directly to the nonprofit organization and help us continue to grow and reach the lives of millions around the world. You can also pick up a copy on one of the online retailers, whether it be Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Books A Million, IndieBound, iTunes, Target. So check it out there. And as you guys know or may not know, you can also win a copy right here. At the very beginning of every month, I announce a winner that wins a copy of the book for themselves or to give forward to somebody else. How do you win? Simply by engaging on the platform. Because I didn't have an opportunity to create a video last week, at the end of the video this week, I will be announcing the winner from the month of January. So be sure to tune in case you are the winner and you need to send me over your address so I can get you a copy of the book. We do have an exciting a promotion going on right now that I want to let you guys know about. So the winner of this past month is also going to receive one of these, and I'm going to show you what it is. We have an exciting promotion going on with our sweatshirts. These are beyond comfy. We have two different designs. This is our Dance for Kindness design. It's a zippy hoodie. It's unisex. It's absolutely awesome. I personally take the extra small in this in case you want to know size-wise, but you could see this all on our website by going to lifevestinside.com. So this shows the brand of Life Vest Inside, so it shows you're supporting the organization, and it has this amazing, amazing design in the back. They are so cozy. I wear this almost every single day, no joke. The other is another really amazing design. I love this one. It looks like this. So again, this one doesn't have anything in the front, but it's the same material, the same brand, really great quality sweatshirts. And we have a promotion going on right now that when you buy one, you get the other one for free, meaning you could gift that forward to somebody else. So check it out. We do have limited supplies because we had this campaign going on for the past couple weeks. So we only have limited stock left in sizes, but check it out directly on the lifevestinside.com website when you go to the shop area. The winner for this past month is going to win a copy of the book and a copy of one of the sweatshirts. So please make sure you stay tuned for the very end. All right, let's jump right into the act for this week. And it's coming to us from February 9th. And like I always tell you, every time I read the act, it always relates to something that happened that day. So here we go. And the act goes as follows. Play Cupid today and introduce two friends who may hit it off. Be mindful that you aren't setting them up for the wrong reasons. And the quote, the meeting of two personalities is like the contact of two chemical substances. If there is any reaction, both are transformed. And the reflection. Traveling down the road of life single-handedly is most certainly possible, but the joy and happiness created when one person finds their counterpoint in another is immeasurable. You can have a hand in the happiness of another, and all it takes is keeping your eyes, mind, heart, and soul opened to see how connections can be made. We've been conditioned to believe that for one person to be at the top, someone else must be at the bottom. This is simply the brainchild of insecurity. The more happiness we bring and infuse into the world, the more happiness is reflected back at us. I never would have thought that such a simple phone call would lead to such a beautiful marriage. When my friend Adam called me late one night, asking if there was someone I might know of to set him up with, I initially couldn't think of anyone. Suddenly, one girl's name popped into my mind. Annie, one of my former students. Suddenly it was clear as day. What a perfect match. I quickly made the necessary calls, and after a few conversations with both of them, a match was made. Dancing at their wedding was a joy I'll never forget. I'll never forget this night. What is the idea? And I know that at the end of this week is Valentine's Day, so you really can connect it to that. But the concept here is really just being mindful for the people that you know in your life and trying to find meaningful connections that you can make. Now, I got to tell you that not only connected to this story, but today, Just today, I happen to be right now in Brooklyn, in New York. For those of you that have been following along over the past year and a half, I've been living in Jerusalem. I'm going to be going back in another couple weeks. But I happen to have been here in New York today, and I went to go get my hair done. And as I'm sitting, getting my hair done and talking with the people that are there and just connecting with them, I was sharing with them that, yeah, I've been living in Jerusalem, and one of the reasons that I made that shift to live there are many reasons, but one of them was hoping to try and find the next chapter of my life, to find my husband wherever he might be. And I figured, there is a phrase that says, when you change where you're living, when you change your place, you also change your fortune, because new things can come into existence. And so one of the people that was sitting there said, wait a second, I know somebody that lives in Tel Aviv, which is a city not far from me. I live in Jerusalem, and it's about 45 minutes away. And you know what? Let me find out. Let me call him. Let me mention. Let me see if he's going out with somebody. Turned out he was going out with somebody, but he asked for a picture of me and, contact information. Said, I'm going to really keep my mind open to see if there's anybody that I can think of. And before she left, doing her hair, she said, you know what? I'm going to keep my mind open because I know that there are other people. Who knows what can happen? Now, obviously, this just happened today. I'm not saying something miraculously is going to happen from this scenario, but it exactly fits the act today. It's simply about being mindful, in terms of helping somebody find their counterpart in whichever way. And it doesn't necessarily need to end in somebody finding their husband or their wife or, getting married. It can also be connecting people that can end up being really, really amazing friends. That's what it's all about. But it's keeping our eyes open. And I'll never forget when I had the opportunity, like in the story I just shared, to make that connection. I want to share one additional thing that I think is really great, because I spoke here in the reflection, I spoke about this concept. I'm going to say the line again because I think it's important that we've been conditioned to believe that for one person to be at the top, someone must be at the bottom. And that this is simply the brainchild of insecurity, because the more happiness we bring in and infuse into the world, the more happiness is reflected back at us. Why did I mention this here? So it actually connects with this past year and a half that I've been living in Jerusalem. Oddly enough. So about a year and change ago, and some of you may have followed this video blog on my personal Facebook page, because that's where I was posting it. I took on 40 days of going to a spiritual place that I'm connected with, the Western Wall. And whether you're connected with that or something else, it doesn't really matter. But the purpose of the story, I was going every day for 40 days because there is this concept that when you continue to do something, when you do something repetitively, it really does have an effect. And so for those 40 days, I was going and I was really connecting with my inner self. And the purpose was to get myself in the mindset of prayer, of connection, to finding that someone in my life. And over the course of these 40 days, I was making a video every single day throughout this journey. If you want, you could check it out on my personal Facebook page. It has like a video each and every day. What ended up happening, I guess accidentally, is that throughout these 40 days, I wasn't just connecting or praying for myself. I was really actually doing it for other people. People were sending me their names. Orly, can you also have me in mind? And this amazing thing happened. This idea of also keeping another person in mind that's praying and looking for the same thing in their life that you're looking for. Having, in a sense, this accountability buddy or partner that's having the same mindset and thoughts and positive energy that they're putting out into the universe for you as you are having for them. There's something really powerful about this. And I think it connects very much with the act today. Because it's talking about playing Cupid. Now, this is all about this concept of matching. Think about anything that perhaps you're looking for in your life, whether it be looking for a spouse or looking for a job or looking for a friend, whatever it may be. And trying to match up with somebody that may be in that same scenario where you're both committing to putting out positive thoughts and vibes for them to find that thing, for that thing to be drawn to them. Because guys, we are energy sources. We put out energy. The energy that we feel inside, whether it's positive or negative, it actually gets reflected out into the world. And that's the energy that we end up attracting back to us. So this might be a really cool challenge. Think about something, and again, you might take the act in one or several ways, whether it's making a match for somebody, on the romantic level, on the personal level, on a business level. You might end up making a great business connection for someone to end up finding a job. Connections are all around us. We just got to keep our eyes open. And if we know somebody that's looking for the same thing, perhaps become accountability buddies, that you're both keeping each other in mind as you're pursuing those things. So that's my challenge to all of you out there. Keep your eyes open, keep your mind open, and you're going to start seeing these opportunities happen around you within the day that you didn't even expect. That's just how the world works, and I find it to be spectacular every single time that it happens. I want to thank you guys so much for tuning in to the Kindness Kickoff. I hope that you continue to join next week. I recently just started a daily video, much shorter than these, that are going up on Instagram or on Facebook, so feel free to check those out. Also coming from the book, and you can check them out there. Everything is at LifeVestInside. Take a moment to subscribe to the channel. I'd love your support to get the messages out there to more people or tag somebody that really might enjoy the message. We have two newsletters that go out, the Daily Kind that goes out once a day from Monday to Friday, and the Kindness Flash that goes out once a month. Check it out on our website. Go to our site, LifeVestInside.com. Click on the sign up button in the top right corner, and there you could subscribe to one or to both of the newsletters. If you're interested in getting further involved in the organization, we are basically a fully volunteer-run organization. And so if you're interested in getting involved, please reach out to me, Orly, O-R-L-Y, at LifeVestInside.com. Love to hear from you all and continue to send those positive messages. They really do bring a smile to my face. Oh my goodness, I almost forgot before we go. The winner of this past month's drawing that will win a copy this month of the Boomerang book, as well as one of our sweatshirts that I showed you guys earlier, is, and the name of the user, because I don't know their name, is Loading Your Name. It's really fantastic. Loading Your Name, I actually mentioned one of the comments that he or she wrote about a couple weeks back, which was really beautiful, that was out on the channel. So congratulations, so excited that you won. Please reach out to me via email, orly at lifevestinside.com, to let me know your address and the size sweatshirt you want, and I will send it over to you. Thank you guys once again, and remember, it's kindness that keeps the world afloat. Love you all. Mwah.